go. Hello everyone, welcome to today's Gabriel Henrique reaction video. That's right guys, it's another one. So, let's have a look at the comments and the donation. So it's a $2 donation from Stu. Thank you very much for that. Hi gents, this is Gabriel singing Oceanos by himself without Pedro. That's my personal favorite version, but everyone is different. So, firstly, before I forget, so Stu is a regular donator to our channel. We really appreciate that. So if you donate to our channel, we will guarantee that we get your reaction video done as soon as we possibly can. And we'll guarantee it because we get so many requests, like so many, that this is, you know, the only way we can guarantee we get yours on. So we have recently done Oceanos with Pedro, which we both enjoyed. Something a bit different, having someone else on there as well. So this is just him on his own. So let's see how he goes.
Me chama sobre as águas, onde os meus pés podem falhar, e ali te encontro no mistério, em meio ao mar, confiarei.
Okay, so we've got something to compare this to, obviously. So how are you finding it? And how are you finding it compared to the version that we listened to with Pedro?
Yeah. I don't want to sound really stupid and this is the comment I'm making. It sounds exactly like the last one, but without Pedro. I mean, it's obvious as that sounds, but that's exactly as it doesn't feel there's any difference apart from the fact we haven't got Pedro in this. And I remember saying in the last one that you could tell Gabriel was probably the strongest singer, and there was no disrespect to Pedro. It that's what it came across. But there was times where they harmonised quite well.
Yeah.
So I do kind of miss Pedro in this. Mm. I do like this version. I do think it's fine on its own. But I think because I've probably done with the Pedro on beforehand, I kind of miss, you know, those tiny bit of harmonizing they're doing and just having that little bit of tiny bit of variation into it. But I think Gabriel's still obviously doing a fantastic job in this one here.
Yeah, I'm going to tell you at the end which version I prefer. Anything is with this one. I'm imagining, imagining Pedro being next to Gabriel, like an invisible Pedro, and it, like, you can't see me, but like with his like emotion, like, oh, you know, like he was doing with his, when he wasn't singing, the kind of, he really,
yeah, okay,
felt.
yeah,
so
yeah,
I, like,
yeah.
I'm kind of imagining that as he's singing. But anyway, we'll talk more about that at the end. But yeah, like you say, I agree with you. It does seem to me, from what I can remember of it, exactly the same, just without Pedro. So totally see where you're coming from.
Thank goodness.
Guíame para quem tudo em ti confie. Sobre as águas eu caminho. Por onde quer que chame.
To say here, so let me just try to say it before I forget. So that's what I actually really like that song. It's the second time we've heard it. Obviously a song we weren't familiar with before. I remember the first song with Pedro was requested by Efrain, and he said that he finds it very emotional when he listens to it. I remember saying that last video that as much as I like the song, I didn't feel that emotion, but for some reason with this one, I felt it more. I don't know why that was, but I did. And that song's really growing on me. I really like it. Obviously, I don't know the original or anyone else who sung it, but I really like it. Really good song. And I like the little bit at the end there, where he gave us his whistle. A really, really good performance. But like we said, very similar to the one with Pedro. And if I was to pick one to listen to, even though I for some reason found this one a little bit more emotional, I think I'd still go for the one with Pedro together, just because it gave that little bit extra. I know I wouldn't say criticize, but I did sort of say maybe they're kind of quite similar singers, but Pedro did come into that, came in a lot stronger at the end, and I think it by the end of it, it did work out quite well. So yeah, really, really good song, really well sung, and I'm starting to feel the emotion even though I don't understand the words, the lyrics. Backstreet Brett, what about you? How did you find that?
Again, I'm going to agree with all the sort of comments that you've made there as well. I also felt the sort of more emotional pull in this performance, and like you as well, really, really like the song. And again, it's been weird because generally without the language barrier, it's normally harder to enjoy some of these songs a bit more, but This one again, Madrone, maybe it's a case of hearing it a second time probably helps. And like you, despite that, I do miss Pedro. I do miss him in it. I think Gabriel, we know what he's capable of. He has got such a good range. He can be there as if there's three, four, five different people there singing that song with him. But I think just having that other person, even though like I said, there was variation with Gabriel and the way he was doing it, just having Pedro there and having that something a little bit different. But I also feel maybe it was maybe the first one we heard, and that's as I'm hearing it, it kind of engraves a bit more. Love both those performances there, but yeah, I'll finish off with saying, yeah, I did miss Pedro, and even though Gabriel was definitely the stronger singer and showed what he can do in that one there, I missed him. I missed Pedro for that one.
Okay. So there we go. That concludes our reaction to Oceanos by Gabriel Enrique. We hope you enjoyed it. I don't usually say this, but don't forget to like and subscribe. As we are on the way to 10,000 subscribers. And then we're going to be big time, massive. So guys, thank you for watching. Obrigado. And we'll see you again soon for the next one. Take care.